Hi, everybody.
Hey, Scott.
It is such an honor for me tonight to introduce and give an award to my congressional representative and one of my longtime heroes, Representative Barbara Lee. So over 17 years ago now, Representative Lee famously cast that lone vote against the authorization of the use of military force. Became a blank check for military interventions and bombing raids in multiple countries that had little or nothing to do with September 11th. Representative Lee repeatedly pointed out the absurdity of the ever-expanding use of military force under that authorization, and history has proven her right. When I moved to the district in 2002, Barbara Lee Speaks For Me stickers were everywhere. I was thrilled that my member of Congress was so brave, and I really felt for the first time that my member did speak for me. It was in 2008, I worked at a law firm in downtown Oakland up on the 14th floor of the Central Building, and down on the third floor was the California headquarters of the fledgling, at the time, presidential candidate Barack Obama. And my paralegal one day told me that Barbara Lee was going to come and speak in a little office down there, and I thought that sounded great, so we went down together, and she came in the office, and there was about 40 people there that day, and she gave a very compelling speech about her colleague and friend, and told us that she believed he was going to be president, and you know what, I believed her. And every day after that, I went down there and made phone calls afterward. And then I spent a month in Reno, Nevada, as the election approached, going door to door. And it was that day that I was politicized. Barbara Lee turned active. You know, there's many ways that Representative Lee vigorously represents and supports the very complex and diverse and progressive 13th District of California. And there's many reasons to thank her, from her founding and continuing membership on the LGBT caucus, her leadership on the Progressive Caucus and the Congressional Black Caucus, and the way she continually fights for the rights of the poor and the disadvantaged and immigrants and communities of color, and her important work to normalize relations with Cuba. But tonight I'm specifically here to thank the Congresswoman for her years of work on the Budget and Appropriations Committees, fighting for more sensible defense spending, and specifically for her efforts to cut dangerous and wasteful nuclear weapons programs. For example, she has offered an amendment to the current National Defense Authorization Act, seeking to end funding for the development of new low-yield nuclear weapons, an issue that many of us are working on here at DC Days on the Hill. And she's co-sponsoring many other relevant amendments, and for that we really thank you. Year after year, Representative Lee has offered similar common sense amendments and sponsored and co-sponsored legislation like the Restricting First Use of Nuclear Weapons Act, which is currently an active bill that we are also working on at DC Days. And we thank you for being such a stalwart ally. Representative Lee, ANA stands with you on the right side of history, committed to achieving a more peaceful and nuclear weapons-free future. It's truly my honor to present you with this year's ANA Award for leading campaigns to cut weapons spending and vocally opposing plans that could reignite a global arms race and heighten the risk of nuclear war. Thank you.
Barack Obama.
Well,
it works. It works. So
so much for this wonderful award, but this is something that is in me. This is something I must do. I have no option to work, except to work for non-proliferation and the end of nuclear weapons. We need to remove them from the face of the earth.
Yes.
I have to just say, I've worked for a great statesman, Ron Dellums, for many, many years. I was also at the day when I worked for Ron, a member of St. Freeze. So, this has been, as I say, part of my life. And I remember marching in a rally on the Mall, in a marching rally years ago, holding a sign that said, a nuclear bomb is an equal opportunity destroyer. Yeah. And I wanted to do that because I wanted the peace movement to include the justice movement. And I wanted the justice movement and people of color to understand we needed to be more involved in the nuclear freeze movement.
That's right.
And so we still have a lot of work to do on that front. So I just encourage you to, you know, we need to broaden our movement. Because the nuclear bomb is an equal opportunity destroyer. And we know now, and I think more people are beginning to realize once this 45th president pulled us out of the Iran deal and now with North Korea, I think more people are becoming aware of the dangers of nuclear weapons. I visited Cuba once. I've been many times trying to normalize relations between our country and Cuba. But on one of those visits, I visited the children of Chernobyl. Cuba took care of a lot of these kids. And let me tell you, to see what happened to these kids was totally devastating, first of all, for me, and I will never forget that. Came back and just, you know, recommitted myself to end nuclear weapons in whatever capacity and wherever I was. Also, I visited Hiroshima. And once again, first ever use of an atomic bomb. I will never forget it. So we have recent history.
Yeah.
We know what in the world can take place in terms of the, in many ways, probably the end of the planet as we know it.
Yeah.
You know, so we have a lot of work to do. And I really thank you for your work each and every day because it's not easy. You all have been at this a long time. And we're making some progress, and I think you're beating the drum a lot louder now, because when you see the debate around, for instance, the amendment that Scott spoke of, there was really no opposition to the amendment to cut $65 million from the warhead in the bill, but they wanted to study it a little bit more, know a little bit more about it. You know, so we did get some language into the appropriations bill that I think is a good sign that members of Congress on both sides of the aisle are really concerned about the stockpile now and about this president and what is taking place in this administration. And so the Trump nuclear posture review, I mean, these are some of the most harmful and controversial recommendations that I've seen. And I think that what you're doing here during your D.C. day is really educating members of Congress to the dangers of this. So just stay with it. Don't give up. Just know that your voice and your work is extremely important. It's extremely important to all of us. And we have to move forward and know that, you know, we can't have a lot of hope unless we know that we're able to feed our children,
that's right,
building nuclear bombs, and so you're providing a lot of that hope for people. We can't have better schools while money is spent on another missile program. We won't be able to live up to our highest ideals if we continue to be a country that values war versus seeking global peace and security during diplomacy. And so we're going to continue to fight to have a rational defense budget over $700 billion. Now, this is outrageous. It's obscene. Waste, fraud, and abuse, rampant. No authorization for these 41 times, these wars around the world that the Congressional Research Service
gave me an unclassified report. Since 2001, you've used force in 41 times, or use that authorization for unauthorized force. You have been drunk attacking men. And so we have a lot of work to do, but I'm hopeful and I'm optimistic that we will continue to fight for peace and to fight for justice. And so thank you again very much for your support.